Hello. So today I'm going to be doing something a bit different from usual. It came up in the Red Candle Discord that there wasn't actually a tutorial going around for Zelda 2 and % No Out of Bounds. Pardon me, I started sneezing my head off immediately before I decided I was going to go live. But I need to get this done. I can't really put it off, so sorry about this. I may be sneezing a little bit. But yeah. When I did an any percent tutorial, it was, as one commenter put it, it ended up being a masterclass. That tutorial took you from zero all the way up to, you know, using world record strats in every single room. That tutorial could take you to a sub 19 run. It was then world record strats. There have been new strats found since then, but you know. But yeah, I can't do that for any percent No Out of Bounds. There are many more rooms in the category than there are in any percent. So I'm gonna do what I can. But you know, this is more of a beginner tutorial than a simple dude level tutorial, which I could do for any percent. So here we go, we'll get started. Again, hold left when you leave this room because you're going to do that. Immediately you're going to go up. Right here, when you get to here, move left a tile. As long as you held left and did that room on the exact same frame every time, you're going to get the exact same encounter spawn every time. This is very important. It's one of the most important things routed into any percent No Out of Bounds. The encounters are the same every time you start here. So hold left, leave, immediately walk, and you'll get that same spawn every time. So we're going to be using that a lot because we're going to up A a lot. By up A, I mean you pause and push up plus A on controller 2. That's an instant game over to let you continue and go back to North Palace. Any percent No Out of Bounds uses many, many up A's. Now I'm going to show you how I do this room, which is not quite the fastest, but there's an ache here. There's two Octoroks, and there's a Gorilla. Now, as soon as you get the trophy, instantly, as soon as you get the trophy, you're going to want to push up plus A and go back to start. Now, let me try to explain what's going on here. The first thing in this room is that you want to jump from this tile and fire beam at that height. Kill that guy, beam, kill that guy. Continue and move on. We just got the trophy. The trophy is needed to unlock the jump spell. Again, exact same encounter spawn, but this time you just want to go left, get out of the way. Because you're taking the trophy to the town of Ruto. This is very straightforward here. You have the trophy. The Gorilla in Tantari Desert, which we just completely ignored, stole the trophy. So we go here, give the trophy to the woman, and a reward for returning the trophy is the jump spell. When this guy talks, he will explain to you what spell you're getting and then the pause screen will pop up. As soon as the pause screen pops up, up A. Okay. And then again, hold left. Again, go left. We're gonna go to the one of the hardest parts of the run is right here. I'm not joking, exaggerating. This is the filter. This is Jump Cave. This is three rooms of torture. First room. Show you some safety skills. What I did was how I do it in speedrun. Move this guy out. But yeah, you've got four Octoroks. Then a Guria. I don't really know what to say, but this is just a gauntlet. There's... Oh, shoot. There's no easy way through it. You just have to practice. Sometimes the game is going to be unfair. Sometimes the game is going to give you patterns you can't really avoid. But you just have to practice and learn to get it out. There's this room. Loader. 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 Loader, Guria. So some possible safety strats. This guy out. Excuse me, I keep doing safety strats and you get hit anyway. Because there's no actual way to do this. In perfect safety. All right, so that's two rooms down. Now, the next room is the break. The next room you can actually do perfectly safe every time as long as you follow a specific strategy. And that's the strategy. It's about two jump stabs. Cast jump. Jump from this tile. See, what's going on is the first jump. Alright, no politics in my channel, please. But yeah. The first jump is about stabbing the ache, which happens to slow you down just enough to manipulate the spawn of the ache man. And then what happens is you jump from a certain specific point, which is about just as the rock on the bottom scrolls off the screen. You jump and stab, and if the ape man is there, you will stab him. If he's not there, he went behind you and you're safe. So either way, you're safe. This is the one room where if you do exactly that, you're safe every time. That room used to drive me crazy back in the day. And then it was pointed out to me, I think by JN, or Simple Dude. It was one of those guys pointed out to me that there's a specific strat you can use, and you're through there every time. So the two gorillas in the first two rooms are still your nightmare, but the third room is cake, once you know that secret. And now I have given you this secret. So now the next step in the run is to get to Babu. You'd like to get through without encounters, but you can't do it perfectly. What we do at the start is to walk in a funny way in order to waste two steps, because we want to get the step counter aligned in a certain way to give us the best chance of blocking. Because there, once you're out of Northern Hyrule, there are two spawns. There's a timer spawn and a step spawn. So we're manipulating both. And ideally, this is what you do. It just works out. And you go here, walk this path into Bagu. And that is the ideal Bagu walk. Let me save state this, in fact. Oops. After I can show you what happens if you don't get an ideal Bagu walk. Go back in here and try again. So let's say you do this. Okay, no big deal. There's a recovery. You still have to get to the swamp. There's no way around that. Then you come here. You want to take a roadie. So you do this. And that walks you into Bagu without taking a very nasty forest encounter. Okay? So now you go into Bagu. When you talk to Bagu, just press B twice to immediately close it up. So now we've talked to Bagu. Bagu, here, I'll show you what he says. Who's the River Man? He's the man at the end of Saria Town that guards the entrance to Death Mountain. When you leave, you do that. Now, this is a particular... How you do this encounter, this bridge encounter, really depends on whether you have beam. I'll show you what you can do if you have beam sword. Don't have beam, then you have to level. Well, pretend I don't have beam sword, okay? That will just lose beam, and then I can demonstrate. You just walk, mess that up. It's just if you lose beam, it's annoying. They're trying to do something, but that was a bad spawn for that. What you really want, if you don't have beam, is for them to spawn in front of you. But if they spawn behind you, you have to... You want to keep walking. You don't want to look back and stab. You want to keep walking. When they spawn ahead of you, just stop and duck. What I'm doing there with that sword, that shield block, is advanced strats, where you're landing on it and ducking, and then you end up blocking it even though it doesn't look like it's in front of you. It's too useful for me not to show it. See, that's why you duck every time one spawns in front of you, because it can fire a rock. Oh, Quad Striker. So yeah, we're doing a tutorial here. But yeah, you want Bean here if you can do it. Beam just makes that very, very easy. And that gets us to Saria Town. Saria Town has a spell we're going to get. Well, actually, what you can get. I'm going to show you. I don't get this spell when I do this. But if you're starting and learning this game, you will want to get this spell. It's the life spell. Hold up left to enter the door as soon as possible. You want to be standing about right here. Push B. Immediately, just push B twice to immediately close up that message. I found a mirror. We take this woman's mirror back to her. And this gets you the life spell. The life spell, because again, you know, when I speedrun this category, I don't get the life spell anymore. But you'll want to. Actually, there's something I forgot. You want to get the magic container by North Palace at the very start of the run. You're gonna get the life spell. Let me show you what that is. I'm just gonna up A here. You won't up A right there. I'm just demonstrating what you would actually do with the starter run. Before getting the trophy, you'll want to go here and do this so that you have enough magic to cast. Stun those guys. Stab that guy. Get the magic container, and then you'll up A. And then you'll go get the trophy. But yeah, anyway. You want to get that magic container immediately at the very beginning of the run if you're going to get the life spell. If you're not getting the life spell, you'll get it later like I did. But yeah, I'm skipping life. You can get life. If you're getting life, you'll want to talk to the magic lady to refill your magic. When you enter this door, don't hold up left. Go slightly past, and then push up. Push B. You can't cancel this conversation for any reason. I have to let him finish talking. See, notice how Link is standing to the left of the door. If you hold up left when you enter the door, he will appear here. But if you wait a little bit, he will appear here. It's a very small time savings, but... It's a time saving, so you might as well do it. It's perfectly free. So now, remember how I said Jump Cave was one of the hardest parts of the run? This is almost as bad. You will want to take this room slowly. You will want to take this room carefully. Start by killing those two bots. Lure this Moblin back. Don't be afraid to use Beam Sword to kill this guy. And I'll show you how to do it. Don't, if you're new to this, don't be afraid of the theme sort of. That bot, that second bot, came from up here. He jumped all the way and came all over here. And then there's another bot on this side. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to use beam sword on every single enemy in this room. I'll show you. This is not how I do this room, typically, but you're much better off not taking damage in this room if you can help it. So don't be ashamed to do that. Okay. In race context, I will take those guys carefully. I will also take that bot carefully. This bot, if he jumps into you, can just ruin your day. So anyway, that's the first room of Death Mountain. Next room. Much safer. We have three Octoroks here. Kill them. This guy. Watch out for the boomerang and get by. If you're new and you want to take this safe, just kill all three of those guys one by one. We got something. You want to duck on that guy when you approach that guy. If you want to do this part faster, you can do a jump. When you jump off that top ledge, you want to wait to jump until Link is almost walking off the edge. Jump as late as possible, and as you're coming down, do a reverse crouch stab to stab the last Octoroth. Next room. There's a bot here. And there's a bot up ahead. If you can see him in your way, just beam him. And there's only so much you can do about those guys. Those guys are nasty. Those three aches. Just. But no, you have to kill at least one thing over there. And if it drops an item, you have to grab the drop immediately. Otherwise, this guy will be despawned. And this guy you just hit with falling crouch stabs over and over. And that gives us attack 2. See, right there, I handled the aches correctly, but the bot trolled me. There wasn't anything I could do about that. There are faster strats you can use to fight these divers, with double hits and whatnot, but I'm not gonna do those right now. You don't wanna do those as a new runner. You really don't. Alright, this room. More trollfish. Use the same strats we used on the bridge. Just duck. When they spawn ahead of you. And keep moving. Yes, this is a tutorial for any percent no out of bounds. Alright, next room. This room is nasty. There's a bot standing on most of these platforms. And in the middle of the room, there's a red diver. That guy throws axes. After you have attack 2, you want to take life 2, just to give yourself a life fill-up. What I did here was a safety strat. I came into the room, killed that guy, lured the diver back, and then gunned him. Where I got hit there, that was a bot jumping down onto me. It's completely random, but will ruin your day. Now, I'm probably making this look fairly easy because I'm not getting killed, I'm not getting beat up. It's okay if you die. It's okay if you take a death, as let me show you. You have two lives to spare here. As long as you don't game over in Death Mountain, you're okay. And in fact, there's a one-up on the way to Bagu in the swamp. If you look at the maps, they're linked on Red Candle. You can see where there is a one-up by a cave, by a boulder cave. You can get that one-up on the way to Saria and give yourself an extra life to use in Death Mountain. Hey, this room's kind of nasty. Wait, and then gun it. Don't take any other levels. The only levels you want to take. Are attack 2, attack 3, and life 2. So keep canceling. Okay, this one's kind of easy. There's a bit there. These are the little red guys, they don't jump. As a kid, I did this. But as a speedrunner, we want to be bold. Divers are easy, they look hard. Now, this is the first drop of the run. As a new runner, you probably want this to be a red jar. Half the time it will be a 200 point bag. Half the time it will be a red jar. If it's a red jar, then that gives you a free cast at the life spell. As a new runner, you probably want that. As a more experienced runner, you want the experience points. But yeah, that room is fairly straightforward. And so is this one. This room has bits instead of bots instead of bits, but it's the same concept. And the reason we wanted that XP is so I can take attack 3 soon. This is what you want during this segment of the run. You want to get attack 3, magic 1, life 2. Here's where I said on the Discord, on the Red Candle Discord today, that it helps if you run 100% all keys, at least a little bit before doing this category, because it tells you where the enemies are. Also, there's a red jar right here. Walk exactly that path, and you'll never get an encounter. And this is Hammer Cave. Immediately leave. That despawns an enemy. I just walked that whole way with no enemy. Let me show you what happens if you don't immediately leave. There's a red diver there. We don't need that 100 experience points, so we just despawn it. Immediately leave and go back in. The rest of the room is kind of dangerous if you're low on life. There's two loaders here. There's an ache man there. There's an ache man there. This room, there's three Megmats. You have to stab and hope for the best. And then there's a Dyra. If you have Beam Sword, there are faster ways to do all of this. In fact, I will demonstrate those. I'm just gonna die here to get back Beam Sword. Sword, those two rooms go so much better. Have Beam Sword if you can help it. If you don't, then do what I originally showed, which is killing the enemies one by one in safety. Okay, this guy. To the right of me, there is a red diver. What you want to do is be walking forward, then jump and let go of the D-pad. That will do what we call a diver jump, where you're basically moving forward in midair without holding right on the or left on the D-pad. That will cause the monster AI to wake up sooner, draw the diver toward you. And you can kill him faster. However, I should have saved stated there. But anyway, so I'll just do this again, and I'll show you what happens if you don't. Show you what happens if you don't do that diver jump. Save state. If you don't do that diver jump and just try to go forward, then he ends up hanging out under that overhang and you can't really fight him very well. Do a diver jump, and in fact, you can walk forward, lure him back, and then fight. And that just makes your life so much easier. This room's fairly straightforward. There's only one enemy in it, and he's on that central platform. Just wait to see where that Mew is going to go. It's a little spiky guy. His AI is very simple. Once he starts takes off in a direction, he'll keep going in that direction. Generally. So just wait to see which direction he's gonna walk in and then go ahead. Alright, final room of Hammer Cave. It's fairly straightforward again. There's this guy. Now what I just did was fairly non-basic. You can get that first hit in safely if you're very quick enough. If you delay at all, then you get hit. So that first hit, you have to get it like immediately. And then you will just annihilate him. However, if you're not secure in that, just wait. Just wait for him to fire to swing the axe and then attack him. That's much safer if you're not real confident. Either way, you know, it's a very small time difference. You need to just go right away or wait for him to swing the axe. Now this red diver is out in the open. Very easy to kill. There are no enemies in the way. There's no hassle. And that was a drop. If it's a red jar, then take your free life cast if you have the life spell. Now, we're not done here. We have the hammer, but we have to use the hammer right here because we're never going to come back to this part. Of the map. So we need to finish up everything while we're here. So we backtrack out of Hammer Cave. Now, backtracking out is pretty easy because we killed everything. The only room that's going to give us trouble is the entry, because the ache men are back. So here's what you do. That guy's going to be the same every time. Fire a beam. And you're out. So there's one final thing to do here. Break this. Push A to use the hammer. Pick up the magic container. As soon as you're holding up the magic container, pause and push up plus A on controller 2. And then continue. And then we're back here. Now, we now have the hammer, which opens up the rest of Western Hyrule. So I'm going to hold left. You want to hold left as soon as you appear, before you appear, so that you start walking as soon as you appear. And then go right. Just hold right as soon as you're out of North Palace. That encounters look like it's going to hit you. And then I'm going to do a manipulation here. You want to have a slight hesitation before breaking that one boulder I broke. And then just keep walking, just like this. I actually messed that up. If you despawn the red dire at the start, he's just gone. He will not come back as you backtrack out of the cave. So again, just a slight hesitation before breaking that boulder is what you need. This is an RNG manipulation. You don't want to break that boulder on the first possible frame. You want to wait a little bit. Just a little bit. Walk up this. Alright. Mash A and get in. Again, this is another trollfish cave. You just need to know where the enemies are. Use your beam sword. And this room is three dires. You don't have to kill them, but it's probably safer if you do. If you're new, killing him is just a lot safer. You kill him, get the medicine, and at bay. But I'll show you how I do that cave. Small delay. There's a different version of this manipulation that requires you to break that boulder frame perfect. But it's not worth it for 1/60th of a second faster to learn the So how I do this room. Jump. Make sure not to dire jump that guy very much. I want to hold right. And that's it. So now that we got the medicine, again, hold left, hold right. It's going to be the exact same encounter that looks like it's going to hit you. Break that boulder as fast as possible this time. Listen for that musical cue. Break the boulder when I broke the boulder, and you will get in there every time. Did you get hit by that guy? When I got hit by that axe thrower, then the safety strat right there is to kind of Dyra jump over the final red Dyra, but land on him on the right side. That will get you past him and give you time to jump over the lava pit without getting hit by an axe. Because the worst thing that can happen here is you get hit by an axe and knocked into the lava. Just as a side note. So, save state this. It's very important that you know what musical cue I'm talking about. Hold left, hold right. Go over the road, mash A. I distracted myself from hearing the cue, but but it's that one note. It's a very distinctive note that you want to break the boulder when it hits. And you always get the backspawn if you do that. That's Feasible's manipulation. You will be using that exact note and that exact musical cue to break that boulder many times during the run, to do many other manipulations. Okay, so right here you cast jump. In fact, you don't have to pause there, because you paused when you hit up A. So you can just push select on that screen. You'll cast jump. You can jump up there, enter the door, and that gets you the down stab. When it plays the item get music is when you can push B to cancel that conversation. Pardon me. So now we're going to trade into medicine here in Nidotown. Almost forgot to mention the name. Give her the medicine and we will get the fairy spell, which is the most important spell in Zelda 2 speedrunning. This is the whole reason we did Dark Jump Cave and Dark Death Mountain, because we wanted fairy. Alright, as soon as he gets fairy, select fairy, and then hit up A. Now this is the point in the run when I get the magic container at the start. If you're getting the life spell, you will want to do this very beginning of the run. If you're not getting the life spell, then you have the advantage of just ferrying through this room. Alright. So I'm going to save state here. So we've gotten the hammer, we've gotten fairy, we've gotten downstab, we've gotten jump. We've done all the item fetch questing that we're going to do on the Western Continent. So now we're just going to go ahead and do the palaces in order of 2, 1, 3. The reason we do it in this order is because leveling is very important in this game. You want to maximize the experience you get from the end of palace gems. And we want to get all the way up to attack 5 after we're done with palace 2. Attack levels are the most expensive, but the most important. So we're going to get an attack level as we complete Palace 2, and we're going to get another attack level from the gem. So for safety, you're going to end up killing a lot of enemies in Palace 2 just to make sure you have enough experience to do that. In like a world record attempt, you would kill fewer enemies and hope to get good drop luck, but in a race context, and I just finished the run context, you're just going to kill certain enemies that I'll explain to make sure you have enough experience to get to attack 5. And by doing that, that means we will be able to get attack 6 from Palace 1, which is just gobs of experience from Palace 1, which doesn't really give you very much experience in an any percent route. So again, hold left, hold right. Because Link moves at a half speed in a swamp, we want to go in here. Now when you go in here, you'll immediately want to leave Lyris. See, there's a manipulation here that is the Arctic Eagle Palace 2 entry. It's not perfect, but it's your best hope for getting through here with as few encounters as possible. Because overworld encounters are just deadly. And that's another random walk. That's the thing. There's no perfect answer here. But I want to show the Arctic Eagle at least once. to show you how, in theory, it works. If you do it quickly, you'll often get a fairy spawn there. Walk up to here. One encounter. One encounter ain't bad. Now, as an alternative to doing the Arctic Eagle, you can just try to tough it out, but I would not recommend it. For a new runner, I would recommend trying the Arctic Eagle there, duck in the cave, do that fancy walk in the swamp, and just hope for the best. As you can see, just trying to tough it out. Did not work out the way we'd like. Oh. Nice back spawn there. There's an important note about encounters. If they're standing directly above you or directly below you, they will tend not to walk into you. It's actually unlucky if an enemy directly below you or directly above you walks into you. They will tend to go left and right. So if you're walking left or right, and the enemy is below you, it should continue to walk below you alongside you and never walk into you. If it goes up into you, you were unlucky. So if you can get them to do that, that's the basic principle of the Arctic Eagle. You're trying to guide them to be, and this is true for encounter skips in general, you want to manipulate that AI. So anyway, Palace 2 entry. Save state. What I just did there is a very small time save. Stab the wall. Actually, I do a crouch stab. You don't have to, but I just do a crouch stab along the wall. And it pushes you to the left or the right. So kill this guy. You want the XP. Fairy. In like a world record type run, you'd want to take some damage here probably to set up an intentional death later, but you don't want to do that. Now this room. This room is a nightmare. Try to show you what can happen in this room by save stage here. These bots, as a safety strat, they'll just want to wait till they walk away, get up here, kill them, get the key. Just respect them, because these bots can knock you into the lava and just destroy you. As a more advanced strat, you want to try to get on the edge of the platform, lead with a beam, and then just like, you want to land and immediately jump and attack again. You're landing while attacking and then immediately jumping again while attacking. So, beam, messed it up. It's beam, land while attacking, jump while attacking. That gives you the greatest possibility of dodging their attacks. Now, if you can see them walking away from you like they are in this pattern, it's easier, but yeah. This room will probably kill you, you know, at least once a stream, especially as you're learning. This room. Kill the Iron Knuckles. These are your first Iron Knuckles. Just jump and hit them as you're falling in the visor. Cancel. Okay, this room. Alright, stab this to be finger magic. There's a way you can just go through these bubbles without stopping, but take your time. It's a very small time loss. Okay, this one. You want to kill this guy, but this guy can give you trouble if you're not careful. Should have saved David. So I get to do this again. When I'm jumping to attack this guy, I'm letting go of the D-pad. That keeps the Iron Knuckles closer to me. Because Iron Knuckles, like Dyrus, will read your D-pad inputs. So you'll end up taking advantage. You can do that and just hop over the Stalfos and kill him on the way out. That's probably safer. Yes, sir. Keep moving. It's more important that you keep moving than it is that you get that pee bag. You can get the pee bag on the way out. Let me show you what happens if you don't keep moving. Right there, I can just barely jump onto that three tile if I jump from the right distance. But I'm now stuck. I can't get through here. You have to leave and go back. So when you get in here, keep moving. Get the pee bag if you can, but don't waste any time doing it. Get through the room. Now this room, there's a red Iron Knuckle. After you kill him, come back and make sure there's no blue bot here. If a blue bot drops from this dropper, and you don't come back and kill it, just like that guy, then it will despawn this guy. You can lure him back. Now watch for that. When you fight this second Iron Knuckle, you run the risk of having him wake up early. So just be mindful of that. And I'll show you some safety strats for fighting that guy. Oh, and one more thing. For those of you with the life spell, you jump up here, red jump. I'm going to show you a trick to fairy while getting a red jar fill up. I have fairy queued up. If I push B then select, I will pick up the jar and then cast fairy. That even works if you have full magic. Just have to be very quick. Because what happens is, you push B and select, so your sword is still going toward the jar as you're pushing select. So you pick up the jar as you're turning into a fairy. So the fairy uses your magic, and then the red jar fills it back up. So okay, if you're gonna fight this guy safely, do this. Then cast fairy, grab the handy glove, and leave. Now here, you want to keep moving, but you don't have to be panicked because you now have the handy glove and you can break these blocks. These guys be left alive. We absolutely want to kill them now. we wanted this to be a 200 point bag. It's a red jar, which means we're at risk of being short XP. So if you've got a 200 point bag there, you don't have to kill this guy. But because we got the jar drop, kill this guy on the way back. You stab that guy on the way down. Be careful. When he does that, you can walk left. And they can disappear soon. Don't be afraid to take it a little safe. Now this room. This room is horrible. Ideally, you'll just do this. Ideally, you'll just avoid everything. Don't kill anything. Get out with your life. But because we didn't get that pee bag, we have to kill these. It's horrible. The reason I'm luring these Stalfros back is to get away from the bullet generators. This third Stalfos will usually despawn. If he does, come back. You need the XP. See, these guys are nasty. They will downstab you back. It's horrible, but you have to kill them. This room's easy. Just keep walking. Get to the elevator. Now, this room can be annoying because there's a bot with the high ground. There's a drop. Again, we wanted a pee bag, but because we got a red jar, we have to kill everything else. Drop down here and get that pee bag. We want to get to, I don't have to kill that guy, but see what happens here? If I have the fairy as low as possible, the Dark Knight goes to sleep. If I move up, he wakes up. Awake, asleep. Awake, asleep. Wake him up. So he comes toward me, put him to sleep, and he walks away. But again, because we got both jars, we have to kill this guy. And that takes us to attack 4. Now, to get attack 5 from the gem, we have to get to 150 XP. The boss will give us 200. So we're good. And the boss is Helmet Head. You have to knock off both helmets. And there you go. Attack 4. You really want to have attack 4 to fight him. If you have attack 3 fighting Helmet Head, you're going to have a bad time. Cancel. Cancel. Grab the key. And place the jack. Don't obey yet! You're going to get 1,800 XP from the gem here. You want to get attack 5 before you up A. Wait. Take attack 5. And then up A. So that's Palace 2 done. Now we're going to go to Palace 1. Again, hold left. And right. Here's how you walk to Palace 1. Go up. Right. This cave's easy. There's just one loader. Jump over him or downstab him. Okay. There's an encounter dodge here. Go ahead and pause when you see it, and just dodge it. And now we're at Palace 1. Yeah, Palace 1 is very easy. We are going to kill some enemies here, because we're going to try to get a red jar drop. Just downstab that guy. Fairy here. You can try to avoid getting hit, but it doesn't really matter much. We're one-shotting guys now. Again, we want to kill these enemies. The enemies I'm killing here are you. That guy doesn't matter, but the big enemies, these Stalfoses, you have to kill. If you're squeamish, you can get the fairy. But it doesn't. Then there's this guy. Two hits. Cancel. Now, I actually got lucky here for a change. Got a red jar. Which will let me cast fairy again. If I didn't get that red jar, I would have had to take an intentional death from that guy's hammers in order to be able to cast fairy there. And then there's the boss. And attack 5. Horsehead is very, very easy. Go back and explain that. The hammer pattern is the same every time. You're basically waiting for a particular gap. As soon as you enter the room, keep walking, jump over the second hammer, wait till he jumps, and fury enter. I'm pretty terrible at ferrying under him. But you can get good at it, better at it than I am. But yeah, you're jumping over the second hammer. One thing you can try to do, and I'm terrible at it, is to stab him and then fairy him. And then that can give you some invincibility frames to get through him. But yeah, you're jumping over the second hammer he throws. That's how you get through the hammers quickly. And that's a better horsehead fight. And again, when you get to the gem, don't up A right away. You're going to get 2,800 experience points here. For attack 6. The leveling is precisely choreographed. You cannot deviate. Or you're going to have a bad time. As soon as you get attack 6, then you up A. And now we're going to go to Palace 3. This is all choreographed. This is all RNG manipulation. Again, walk left, walk right. Mash A. Wait for the Q. Walk there. You're taking an encounter on that road. Queue up. Make sure fairy's queued. Walk to here. Immediately fairy. That's all just rote memorization. This room, there's a Mew, a loader, and then a loader, and a Gilead. So that can be tricky. The up A glitch involves saving, and no, don't do it. Dark Magician, don't do it. Do not deviate from the plan. Do not deviate from the experience plan. I need to show you how to do this. As soon as you get out here, walk to here. When the encounter spawn happens, walk this path. That was actually really unlucky. Just block the path. And we're in Palace 3. You can go for a red jar here, but it doesn't actually matter. Unless you've got the life spell and you want to cast life. Because we actually get to start taking magic and life levels here. Here's your first big combat test. Do not. Immediately take magic, and that's why we don't care about the jar. This guy is evil. I'm just gonna skip him. This room, jump over the first Tinsu. Do not kill it. Do not kill it. If you kill the first Tinsu, then you avoid despawning one of the four Mews in the room. Now, you may have only seen three there. That's because I jumped over the first Tinsu and despawned it. It just makes the room so much easier if you despawn that fourth Mew. Jump over the first Tinsu. Always jump over the first Tinsu. Don't kill it. This room, just keep walking. You will very rarely get trolled by the blocks. Just keep walking. You will very rarely have anything happen. You can normally just walk straight through that room with nothing happening. Occasionally you'll get hit in the head by a block, but that's really unlucky. Really unlucky. This room. Watch the Mew on the left. He went right. You want him to go left. I might kill that guy for the XP. But yeah. You can get that P-Bag. I kill this guy. Now, the way I just killed him was I was doing jumping crouch stabs. I was pushing A, down right, B. And then that got through his shield. And now, I take life 3. Okay, these jumps, these 3 tile high jumps, I just did it without thinking. You want to jump from the third tile away. So this is 1 tile away from the platform. This is 2 tiles away from the platform. This is 3 tiles away. You want to jump from right here. And you'll get up. And again, for this next one, it's 3 tiles away. There's 1, 2, 3. We're going to jump from this block. Again here. 3rd tile away. I mean, you can do this with granny strats by breaking that block, getting up there. And if the Mew is standing right on this block, you have to. You have to use this granny strat. But otherwise, you just want to jump off with the right thing and do that. Oh, getting too much experience. Taking a wrong level can ruin you, Dark Magician. So what I just did here was I lured that guy to the left. And killed him. Watch your XP. You don't want too much. Okay, this room. Watch the bots. Okay, this part's tricky. Do not take the key. Do not take the key. Do not kill the Iron Knuckle. Okay? Do not take the key. Do not kill the Iron Knuckle. So now notice, I have 247 out of 300 XP. Make sure Fairy is queued up. Cast Fairy before you get the experience from the blue Iron Knuckle. And you will get Magic 3 as Fairy. So notice I have full magic. I got that Fairy cast for free because the experience was perfectly choreographed. And yet that level came at exactly the right time. That's also bad. Do not kill the key and take the Iron Knuckle. Now when you come back in here, Simple Dude will often cast Jump in here. Let me show you Jump Strats. Let me do better Jump Strats than that. And the reason Jump is so safe in here is that getting higher lets you manipulate that red Iron Knuckle better, and it lets you have a better angle when you're going after the boss. See, without Jump, that guy's lower on the ground. But yeah, now you take the key. So yeah, you don't have to cast Jump in there. I mean, you might end up wanting to cast Life instead if you had the Life spell, but casting Jump there is kind of nice. Come out. Again, if you have the Life spell and you need some extra magic, you can stab that statue, but it's not a guaranteed jar. It's only a 50-50 shot. You can actually grind it if you desperately need a life cast. You can leave and come back and try again. But again, if you just die once here in Palace 3, it's fine. You've got lives to spare. Now this room. That guy's a drop. So now, in this room, we're gonna fairy here, but we're gonna fairy in a very particular way. We're gonna get on what's known as the perfect pixel. Let me save state. So I'm gonna just naively cast fairy. Go up and up. This doesn't work. This is wrong. I just got hit by that guy. What you want to do is come at it from the side. I'm higher up than I was before. See? No damage. No damage. Oh, he jumped in. That was unlucky. If he didn't jump into me, it would have been. So this is the perfect pixel. This is also something developed by Feeble. That guy's trolling my face off right now. I mean, if they jump into you, they jump into you. But as long as they don't jump into you, like that. That's how you want that room to go. Just get on that perfect pixel and go. Alright, again here, let's see, one tile, two tile, three tile, jump from right there. Now here's what you do, break these blocks, and for safety, hope that guy leaves the screen, then come down. Fighting that red Iron Knuckle can be difficult. Fighting that red Iron Knuckle is why I learned the claw grip. I don't know if you can see it, but I hold the controller like this. I'm using the tips of my index and middle finger to push B and A respectively. That way I can Hit A then B really quick. This is how I fight this Iron Knuckle. Push in A then B really quick. Maybe you're good at doing it with your thumb. But back when I learned this, you can do the perfect pixel anywhere with or without an elevator. It's just that because you enter that room on the elevator, you end up doing it on the elevator. But you can do the perfect pixel anywhere. You could do the perfect pixel in the raft room. In some categories, you just want to ferry through that room. And so you might want to do the perfect pixel to get over the blue Iron Knuckle. So anyway, I think we are short 100 XP. I think we need 700 XP here. So we have to kill this guy. Again, same thing. A then B. Yep, we need 700 XP. The boss gives 301. So, before you kill the boss, check your XP. Make sure you have at least 399 when you enter the boss fight. Check your XP. You need 399. Now, there's two ways to fight Revenant. I'll start by showing you the advanced one. Stand on this tile. And just gun it. Yes, Revenant gives 301. Notice I have 758 XP. He gave 200 in the FDS version. They changed it to 300 in the NES. But they typoed it, and instead of 300, they made it 301. Anyway, here's the safety strap for Revenant. Stand on this exact tile. Jump over him. When he stops, go to the left edge. And just do that. Actually, no, you want to stand on the half tile. Sorry. Now stand on the half tile. That way he's right lined up at the edge. Yeah, it was meant to be 300, but they typed. So again, apologies. It's been a while since I used this strat. You want to stand on this half tile. Wait till he stops, then walk over. And normally, he will stay under you. Just finish him off like that. So, let him act down. 301 XP, cancel. And we're going to get 4,300 experience from Jim. Again, don't up A immediately. Take your attack 7. Seven. Up A. Now we're going to go to Palace 4. Again, this part is all pure scripted RNG manipulation. Oh, the power pack just glitched. Power pack just glitched out there. I'm using the power pack. Sometimes the power pack overheats and does something crazy like that. Ignore that. That was the power pack that came out. This is why you never want to use power pack to do a run. Now I'm all flustered. I went too soon. You don't want to use a power pack to do runs. If you want to use a flash cart to do a run, you want to use the EverDrive. The EverDrive doesn't have that problem. So yeah, break that boulder on that cube. Keep walking. Keep walking. Keep holding right. Walk down three tiles. Dodge. And in. That's the you're gonna be able to do that every single time. Every single time you can dodge that encounter as long as you do the Feasible Boulder break. So coming in here, downstab that guy, use a beam to stun that guy, use a beam to stun that guy, bounce, be ready to block. Here's another encounter manipulation. It's fairly reliable. Fairly reliable. Immediately glitch hold. Whoa. We glitched here. What the heck? I'm getting wraparound hit by the River Zora. But never mind that. You have to go immediately when you come out. Stop on that tile. Stop on that tile. Go up. So that manipulation is fairly reliable. You just gotta learn it, practice it. Here, last fairy. Fly over the orange Lizalfos. Grab the kid. Now we're gonna leave. Go to this spot, but do not take the one up yet. Do not take the one up on the way to get the reflect spell right now. Do not take this one up. Leave the one up. Leave the one up. You need it later. For any sort of reliability race strats, you absolutely need to leave this one up for later. I am not joking. So anyway, we're gonna do a manipulation here called the Dazzle. It's really reliable. It's not perfect. No encounter manipulation in this game is perfect, but this is one of the more reliable ones. If it works, it will get you all the way to the first encounter skip. Listen to the music. Just go. Second spawn. Up. Up again. Stop. Stop. Those guys despawn. Wait here. Perfect. That's the Dazzle. That's the full unicorn. Right here. Counter skip. Perfecto. And we are in the town of Darunia. Glitch out Link here. So what you want to do is you want to, be having your magic refilled as you leave this screen. Queue up fairy. Hold down and press select. It's important on this screen, you're holding down as you press select. See, if you just cast fairy here, you can't get into the wait, what am I doing? Never mind all of this. I'm teaching you how to do the fairy claws, but you don't want upstab in 80% you want to balance. Ignore that. You don't care about filling up magic. You don't care about casting fairy there. I've got the 100% all keys tournament on the brain today. That's the fairy clause for 100% and 100% all keys. You don't need that for this. The only reason you're in this town is to talk to this lady. Ignore all of that about the magic lady. Ignore all of that about casting fairy. It's completely irrelevant for this category. You don't want upstab. You don't need upstab. You're not going to get upstab. And you're going to like not getting upstab. You're just going to get reflect. Just reflect. And as soon as it pops up, upstab. Now this is a critical part of the run. This is where, if you're new to this, you're going to lose runs at this section. Unless you follow my safety strats. Our small six count is now zero. We want it to be... We want it to be at 4 or 5 when we enter Palace 4. It's very important. Kill this guy. It's not 1. Kill this guy. It's a 2. You have to kill all 3 of these guys. 3. Do this manipulation again. Troll fairy. Now we have to improvise. That bad fairy luck just cost me up. Now you get the one up. It's urgent that you get the one up right now. So you can't get trolled out of the entire run. So you get that one up, and now you're going to take the long way around to get to Palace 4, to get the required magic container, and to the minimum encounters. So note, my small 6 count is now at 3. Fairy to pick up the container. My small 6 count is at 3. Pay attention to your small 6 count. You have to have it at 4. When you kill this guy, it's going to be at 4. You want to be at 4 or 5 right here. You want to have your small 6 count be at 4 or 5 right now. Fairy's cute. Come down here. Fairy. Do the perfect pixel, but it doesn't really matter. Okay, this room. Cast jump. Break that without upstab. Kill that guy. Now we're gonna die. This is an intentional death. Just get hit by the magic. It's faster than getting hit by the tin suit. So we die. Fairy again. Take the perfect pixel. Now. Here's why we set our 6 count to 4. We do not have enough magic to fairy again. We do not have enough magic to fairy again, but we want to fairy again. So we're going to get a blue jar in this next round. Jump into them, jump back. Blue jar. Now, the reason you get the one up is that 1/8 of the time, that blue jar is going to be a 50-point bag. You have to take an intention to that. But we got the blue jar. So we ferry here. Take the perfect pixel. Take a death. Just to make sure you have enough. Good evening. Again, you need to make sure you get the 700 XP. You have Reflect. Cast Reflect in here. Garak. Go to the right edge. Rep plays Chuck Mangione music during this fight. And we're good to go. Now, normally at these gems, I say don't up A right away. As soon as you can hold right, so that as soon as you can walk, you start walking. Leave, come back, and keep going. Chuck Mangione. Probably the song Feels So Good. Take Attack 8. See, we're not done with Palace 4. We beat Karoth. But we're not done. We're just gonna hustle to this side. Let's go for the ceiling walk. Completely optional, but missed it. Just missed the ceiling walk. Here. See, here you could do the perfect pixel, I'll show you. But you don't have to here, because you're going to get the boots and immediately up A. So now, Palace 4 is done. We're going to go to Palace 5. Again, this is all scripted. This is my favorite overworld part of the run. Because with the RNG manipulation, we can loop the overworld music. Unless I botch it, because I'm talking. See, I mean, for me, that is purely an auditory cue. So if I'm sitting here talking and doing a tutorial, then I'm likely to botch it. So I need to close my mouth and listen. Like that. Down. Skip to 10. Listen to the music. Completely leaked. We want fairy queued here. Okay. You want to jump on this, jump from the second tile. Keep talking, it messes me up. Basically, I jump from the second tile for all these guys, and that lets me kill them easily. chocolate. And you can do this. Sometimes this final guy will despawn. If he despawns, just come back. We've now set our small six count to 5. Next step is to ferry here. Now again, we're just short of the magic we need. Okay. So we want a jar, and we ferry out of here. There is an alternative to that, but it's very difficult. I'm just gonna see if I can pull it. See, I despawned the fifth guy there because I don't actually care. See if I can pull this off. It's called the Eco Key. It's been months since I've tried to practice it. So I'm not gonna get it. But I'm just gonna see if I can try. There's a way you can damage boost up here. But I haven't done it in a long time. I don't even remember the key. Almost got it there. I'm not gonna get the eco key. There's a video on YouTube on how to get the eco key. I suggest you watch it. Simple Dude made it. See if I can get it once, just to show it off. You don't have to do this. The alternative is to make your six count at 5. Forget it. Alternative is just to make sure you come back and kill this guy. Set your six count to 5. Ferry in here. You can do the eco key if you want. It adds a great deal of reliability to the run. And it's faster. Yeah, I don't remember the cues for the eco key. I haven't practiced it in many months. So I was probably doing it all wrong. I don't remember where to stop. I don't remember where to jump. I just don't remember. I haven't worried about the eco key in a long time. So yeah, we have our six count at 5. So we need a blue bar here. If you get 50 P bag there, start crying. Then you're gonna have to probably just leave and come back or something. Don't go around killing extra enemies here. You want your XP to be at a certain amount. Ignore that key. That key's for chumps. Chumps running all keys. We're running a real category. You want that red jar. Cue up jump. But not for the reason you think. In this room, cast jump. Grab that bag. Skip. Cast fairy. Try this. Grab the jar. Kill that guy. Fairy. You don't need the perfect pixel here. Now we're gonna kill Boss Duma. I'm gonna try to yak count a couple times just for giggles. Don't try to yak hammer. Don't try this at home. There you go. There's your Boss Guma yak hammer. Now this is very, very tricky. Cue up fairy. Cue up fairy. Hold left as soon as you press this gem. Run, 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 run. You're in a race. You want to leave this screen. You want to leave this screen and then cast fairy. We got out. So now, we're going to take a whole bunch of levels. Lure this guy back. You don't have to lure him back. I'm just showing you how to do it for safety's sake. Come down. So now we have full magic in Magic 7. Get through this guy's hammers. Cast fairy. Fairy is now cheap. 2.5 bars. Cast jump here. If you jump from that tile, I'm gonna show you what happens when you don't get that jar. You don't need it. You don't need a jar there. It doesn't matter. Oops. You don't. Again, don't try to yak hammer Boss Goomba. That's a completely unnecessary risk. I'm just doing it to show off because I'm using save states and I can have that luxury. And the reason I just loaded state there is because I got hit by that bubble and I was at risk of not having enough magic to get the. Make sure you don't take attack 9 here. Taking attack 9 is bad. Taking attack 9 will make you cry. Save state. Sadly, you do not kill things faster with attack 9. This guy's very annoying. You don't want to get hit by bubbles because they do drain your magic. So be careful. So we got a pee bag. Switch back to fairy. This time, don't try to upstab that guy. I have upstab on the brain today. I actually take attack 9 in FDS version of this category. But that's because it's... That's because of Charon. That's because of Charon. So again, we didn't need that red jar. We have enough experience to get through. Cast Fairy. Yes, Attack 9 gives you a 1-up, and I actually do need the 1-up in FDS. You can perfect pixel there, but you don't really need to. Just grab the recorder and immediately up A. Now we're going to Palace 6. There is a manipulation to get all the way to the River Skip. Perfectly, but I don't know it. I don't know it. So, I'm going to show you the fallback. And again, I just messed that up because I was talking. I never mess that up if I'm just doing a run. But if I'm doing a tutorial, I mess it up almost every time, apparently. It's really easy to do this. Just like that. That's not hard. So anyway, if you don't know the perfect manipulation to get all the way to the River Skip, here's your fallback. Just go to town. Leave. Come down to this cave. Leave. And do this. River Skip. Using that cave is how we do it in any percent deathless. So it's a perfectly reasonable fallback. Just fairy here. However, you may not want to fairy through both of those and save a fairy cast. So do one of these the old-fashioned way. On your feet. And save a fairy cast. The reason you're going to want to save a fairy cast because of the cave coming up. Okay, here's a manipulation. Enter the bridge, leave, and then walk up, go here. Look at the spawn, and troll. Those who watch Simple Dude know this is just pure torture. You hope to get a good spawn. And if you don't get it, you don't get it. But be careful, you can get through. So here's why you want a fairy cast. To fairy over this room with three Tektites in it. This room, bounce on that guy. There's a red one here, just Dire Jump, bounce over. And break that. And this is the new Kasuto Town. Now, at a high level, you're just gonna talk to her and go. But there's a safety strat you can do. You can make your life easier if you come get the spell. I'm gonna get it just to show you what you can do with it later. I'm just gonna get it. I don't get it when I do Renzi this. I'm skipping spell at this point. But I'm gonna get it so that when it comes up later, I can demonstrate how to use it. Nope. You don't need to fill up your life there, but it doesn't really hurt, except for a very small time loss. So then, either get spell or just immediately talk to this lady. Cue up fairy. Fairy in here. With the 8th magic container. You need all the magic containers to get the thunder spell. So you have to come to this town, even if the only thing you get is that container. Spell costs you about a minute to get, so it's up to you. It's useful for Valley of Death. This room. There are 3 tech types. Try to bounce over them. I bounced over 2 of them. Not bad. Okay. Encounters here. First spawn. Nowhere I could go. Now beware, there's a forced encounter right here. You don't want to enter here. Entering here is very annoying and sad. But once you get to the forest, you come to this tile, get a heart container, which lets you manipulate your way into Palace 6. Usually without an encounter, but once in a while you get one. But anyway, Palace 6. Have fairy queued up. I want to hit the perfect pixel here. Some of you who watch Symbol Dude may notice when I compliment him getting the perfect pixel really quick. The perfect pixel is just so useful there. Here, this guy just wants a yak hammer. Now, how do I go for the ceiling walk? I have a particular pattern for going for the ceiling walk. Jump right here. Tap right, do a full height jump. Do a full height jump and ceiling walk. The ceiling walk is nice here, but it's not essential. The ceiling walk does give you an extra fairy cast though, so you can go for it, but if you don't get it, now I'll just show you what happens if you don't get the ceiling lock. There's fairy here. Queue up fairy. The ceiling lock is not necessary. In this room, just stay alive. Just don't die. Do whatever you need to do. I'm not going to grab that jar because there's no guarantee to get it. This room is pretty easy. Block the magic. Kill the red iron knuckle. This room. You will see Simple Dude do this really FPS thing where he jumps and then fairies as late as possible. That's literally just giving away frames for no reason. You want a fairy as soon as you're in the room. Because fairy accelerates faster than Link. Then come back and get a red potion to refill your magic. It looks like a lava bath, but it's secretly a red potion to refill your magic. Fairy here. Rebinac. With attack 8, you don't want to use the left side, but you can if you want. You just want to destroy it as fast as possible. Okay. There's a safety 1-up you can get in here if you really want. Jump. Move this guy back. Kill the bubbles. Again, bubbles drain your magic. You need enough magic here to get the fairy spell cast. So be very careful not to get your magic drained by those bubbles. Have fairy queued up. Cast fairy here. Barba. Queue up jump. Don't stop moving. Hold right. Don't stop moving until the screen stops. Now you can... Yak hammer. Hey, guys, I never yak hammer, but I just wanted to show you guys that yes, I do know how to yak hammer at attack 8. I tend to play it safe though. And one cycle them that way. Fight them any way you want, but. Don't take life 6. You're gonna take magic 8. Don't up A! You're not gonna up A here. You don't wanna up A here unless you're low on lives and you need to reset your lives. But that's why we took that extra life. Just leave immediately. Then you can ferry for free on this bridge. Because we're gonna get magic 8 to refill our magic. Magic 8. We're gonna get the thunder spell. Here's where things get difficult. There's an enemy in this town we can't see. Just start downstabbing. And hope you stab him. You can't cast spell in that town, so don't bother trying. Well, you can cast spell, but it won't turn the guy into a bot. So we get the thunder spell. Get. Start down stabbing. Hope for the best. Okay, the bridge. Have fairy queued. Because if something goes wrong, you want to be able to fairy on out of there. Don't lose any time crossing from one bridge to the next. If you waste any time there, you will get an encounter. Again, if you're worried, just ferry these bridges, but it's easier if you save some magic. It's also easier if I get better spawn patterns. I keep getting back spawns, and I want forest spawns. Once you get here, go into the forest. There is a red jar here. I don't need it. Okay, Valley of Death encounters. When you get a big one, cast jump, make your way through. The small one. Do that and then get trolled at the end. But yeah, Valley of Death is dark. It's unbelievably nasty. Simple Dude will tell you he clenches doing this anyway. Here's the most nastiest, most horriblest room in the entire line. Here's where you'll wish you had life spell. This room. It's just, ugh. Yeah. You can just die here with nothing you can do about it. And then Max. Scorpion Max. This guy, just bounce over him. He'll throw to the right. Now let me show you an alternative to just Dark Valley of Death. Cast the spell. That's why you want spell if you're a new player, so that you can cast spell and turn the MOAs into bots. And then do that. Through. As soon as you're in Palace 7, as soon as you're on this screen, up there. Refills your lives, refills your magic. Spicy chickens are horrible. Be careful. Fight them standing up. Do not crouch stab. Most enemies in Zelda 2, you're crouch stabbing. But these guys stand up. Their hitboxes are skewed toward the top. If you're crouching, you'll whiff them while they hit you. It's really horrible. Okay, right here, there's a pit. Jump over the pit. Go right here. Palace 7's a maze. If you go the wrong way, you'll end up going to a dead end or getting stuck back at the beginning. So just memorize the path. Spicy chickens on flat ground aren't so bad. Run into the fire, stab, and bounce. This room. Practice this room more than almost any other room in Zelda 2. Really nasty pen there. This guy, you want those knights to jump over you. Break those two blocks. But the thing about that guy, if that red knight is jumping right at you as you're entering the room, don't hesitate to just leave and come back and reset him hoping for better RNG. I'll show you. There's a similar room later. I'll show you how to do it. Queue up fairy. Fairy over this guy every time. Every time. Just fairy over him. This guy. Hit him like that. You want to hit him with, from the side. If you have the life spell, then you can do this and go for a red jar. But half the time, that will not be a red jar. Half the time, that will be that guy, and you just come back and try again. So if you have the life spell and you want a fill up, you can just grind this for a jar. It's 50-50, but some runs you will just get a lot of knights in a row. Okay. This run, cast jump. You want to walk right up to the edge and jump and push B to break those rocks. This guy, let him jump over you, run, do the same. Double block break jump will save your life. But I will show you how to do this without the double block break jump. I'm sure you don't know how to do that. I'm gonna do this. Notice how we're one tile lower? You can push him back. In fact, if you want to be even safer than that, if you want to be completely wimpy, you can just stand here. Oh. Okay. Don't stand that close to the edge. Don't stand that close to the edge. So anyway, let's once again show off our safety strength. Again, we're one tile lower than the double block break jump will give us. Stand about right here. You can just kill him. You can just stand right here and kill him in perfect safety. As long as you don't walk too close to the edge. Gavin? But again, much faster and, as Scavenger points out, much safer is to do your double block break jumps. Jump up, let him jump over you. Get in there. Botch the jump like an idiot. But yeah. You never want to jump over that guy. Let him jump over you. Every time. Every time. You want to jump and hit that guy late as possible so he fires to the left. This room, you can fairy if you want to. Yeah, someone joining the bounty race asked for a tutorial of this, so I did a tutorial of this. Okay, so there's another one of these rooms. If that guy does that, just run away. Just run away. Just leave the freaking room and come back again. If he gives you a nasty pattern like that, it's the same with the red one. They give you a bad pattern. Just say nope, nope, nope. And then you'll get a decent pattern. Let him jump over you. Duck. And get out of dodge. Fairy here if you want it, but be very careful getting it. Break one block at a time. Don't dig yourself into the pit. On this side, there's a 1-up. Don't die getting the 1-up. Or you can just go without either of those. Fairy over this guy. I'd love to see him. Okay, this. There are two blocks here. The fifth and the sixth. get you to this pit. This guy, boss bot, just bounce over. Now this room. Just keep jumping so that you keep that bubble out of the way. And then you drop down to here. You can take an intentional death here to refill your life and magic. It's very common for more experienced runners to do that, but it is not required. You do not have to. You can refill your magic right here. That's a 50-50. If you get the red knight, just leave to the right and come back. Yeah, but be careful when you leave to the right here. This is Thunderbird's room. Don't walk too far. Because you need to have enough magic to cast Thunder. So yeah, half the time that will be a red knight. And half the time it's a red knight. But let's say you have the life spell and you're casting life. And you steal me even more magic. Well, don't worry. There's a second one right there. And again, half the time that's a blue, red knight. The red knight, you can leave and come back. But anyway, so you can either use an intentional death or those red jars to fill up. So now we are at Thunderbird. There are many ways to fight Thunderbird. I prefer not to use jump if I don't have reflect. I'm going to cast Reflect, Jump, queue up Thunder. Do not cast Thunder unless the head is on screen. You need Thunderbird to be on screen. Now that's the bold way to fight him. If you're comfortable fighting Thunderbird, it's safer to fight him jumpless. Just cast Reflect. Queue up Thunder. Getting 3 hits, ideally. 2 hits coming back. Now, I got hit there, but normally Reflect will save your bacon. So either way, Thunderbird's down. Dark Link. Dark Link, there's 2 ways to fight him. One is just go left. This is good enough. Just keep mashing B. It goes down. Hold right after Dark Link final hit. Hold right, and when Link stops moving, you're done with the game. There is, however, an RNG manipulation for Dark Link. You get it perfect, it's what I call the ultimate fight plan. Almost got it there. That was pretty good. If you get it perfect, you will hit him 8 times in 8 tries, and he goes down perfect. And that is Zelda 2 Any Percent No Out of Bounds. Any questions? Any questions? This will go on YouTube. Hello, YouTube. But before I shut this down, I'm going to open it up to questions. not seeing any questions, so I guess I covered everything. Again, your really nasty parts of the run, as you're learning, are going to be Jump Cave, Death Mountain, Palace 4, and Valley of Death. Those are going to... Don't feel bad if you have trouble there. Why does Luigi have a sword? Because he's tired of being the second fiddle. That's why he has a sword. So anyway, I want to get into just a little bit of Bounty Race studying myself tonight. So this is going to be it for me. Again, this is going to be, most people are probably going to watch this on YouTube. And I will put this up as soon as I can.